देख रहे डिस्कनेक्ट हो गया। एक मिनट रुको, यहाँ बैठो एक मिनट।
ओके आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू. गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. काइंडली राइट इन चैट बॉक्स दैट आई एम ऑडिबल. Yes, am I audible now? Okay. So, good morning, and I welcome you all on behalf of Guru Gobind Singh Inprastha University. And this is basically the CET preparation for Guru Gobind Singh Inprastha University. And on behalf of Gitaratan International Business School, we are organizing the MBA CET coaching, MBA CET crash course, you can say. I am Tapan Kumar and I am assistant professor and working as assistant professor in Gitaratan International Business School. And I am taking this numerical ability section forward. Okay, so whatever you have studied till date is the basic aptitude section, and this is basically advanced mathematics section. So very first suggestion is, if you are pretty sure with the concepts, pretty sure with the idea of higher mathematics, then you should attempt this section, and hardly you will get 2-3 questions from this section. Okay, So if you have fair idea of this permutation combination section or probability, then you have to attempt this. Okay. Otherwise, I would suggest probability section you can attempt, or if you have idea enough, if you have enough idea about this, I hope it is visible. Is it visible? You can zoom this slide at your end also if it is not visible. Okay. So when we talk about permutation and combination, first thing we have to keep in our mind that permutation is something called arrangement. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can write in the chat box. I will be responding. Okay. So when we talk about the permutation, this is something called arrangement. And when we talk about the combination, this is something called selection. So in this section, I will brief you about permutation, combination, and third thing is probability. I hope all of you are attentive. Kindly pay attention towards this, because this is numerical ability section and you have to be keep your energy level high so that you can practice maths or higher maths based question. And it is a very easy section if you will pay attention towards it. Okay, so moving towards this, the content. So what I have told you, that when we talk about permutation, it is called arrangement, and when we talk about the combination, it is called selection. So when you see the word arrangement in the question, we have to apply the concept of permutation. When you will see the word combination in that case, or selection in that case, you have to apply the concept of combination as well. Okay, so in order to start with permutation combination, this is very, very first thing is you have to pay attention towards the counting principle, which is very fundamental principle of probability or permutation combination section. So counting principle is very basic. So counting principle says that if there is, suppose there is a railway station, let's say A, B and C, there are three railway station, and you have to move from A to C. If you are, you have to move from A to C, and there are defined path such as there is M path or M ways that you can move from station A to station B, and there is N ways or N path that you can select while moving from B to C. So in that case, this is very basic and fundamental principle, and in that case you can just multiply these two ways or these two number of paths, and you will get the final answer. So let's say there is a question like there is eight paths from A to B and five paths from B to C. So in that case, what is total number of ways that you can move from railway station A to railway station B? So simply your answer will be 40 in that case. Okay, so this is called fundamental principle of counting. When you have given choice like this, you can apply this principle called fundamental principle of counting. Okay, I hope it is clear. If it is not clear, kindly ask your question in chat box. I will reply. Okay, I hope it is clear. It is very basic. Similarly, if you have some number of objects and you can select in some particular way, let's say M number of objects are to be selected, and again you have some option that N number of object can be selected, you can remember like this. So if this one, let's say I am calling it as 2, second, and this is third. So this is very fair approach that you have to choose third while choosing the second object. Let's say question is like this. Then in that case, net formula is M multiplied by N. So it is very clear. You have to always remember that the total permutation or total object you can select in these two M and N object is M into N ways. So this is something called fundamental principle of counting. Okay, I hope it is clear now. Now when we come across this word called permutation, so permutation is something called, let me talk about the concept. Permutation is something called arrangement of object. So when we talk about arrangement, we have to remember one very basic formula. As you are not supposed to crack ITJE, that's why you have to pay attention towards the basic formula only, and it will be sufficient for MBA CET. Okay, so when we write NPR, it is something called factorial n divided by factorial n minus r. Okay, so this is very first formula when we come across the permutation. Okay, just note down the formula. Okay, we'll be using this formula when we'll solve the question which is asked in previous year papers. Okay, I will be giving you some question which is directly taken from the previous year question papers, and I will be solving in front of you. Those questions are very simple question if you pay attention towards this concept. So now, what is permutation? Basically, permutation is if some object is taking r at a time. Let's say we have n object and we have taken r object at a time. Now, one thing is very important to note that repetition is not allowed in this section. Repetition means you cannot choose one item twice. So if repetition is not allowed, then in that case it is NPR. So if question talks about the arrangement of R object out of N object, if you have to arrange R items out of N items and repetition is not allowed, then in that case permutation is applied. You have to very sure that when to apply permutation, when to apply combination. It is very basic misconception that students are applying permutation in place of combination and combination in place of permutation. So you have to be very clear about this concept that when it talks about the arrangement and repetition is not allowed, in that case, we can say that NPR is applicable. Now, can anyone tell me that if repetition is allowed, then how much, then what is basically the formula you can say? Let's say, I am giving you a question. Let's say there is five items. And out of these five items, you have to arrange three items. Okay. If you have to arrange three items out of five and repetition is not allowed, in that case, answer is 5P3. Okay. And now my question is, if repetition is allowed, then what is solution in this scenario? If repetition is allowed. If you know, let me know. Okay, fine. If repetition is not allowed, in that case, we have seen that it is 5P3. You can again solve it in the form of factorial. If repetition is allowed, in that case, formula is n raised to the power r. Okay. So in that case, answer is 5 raised to the power 3. I hope it is fine now. Is it fine? Okay. So you have seen two formula, which is very important. One is repetition is allowed, and second is repetition is not allowed. Okay. Again, one thing, I hope all of you are familiar with this, that factorial n can be expanded in the form of n multiplied by n minus 1, and ... so on. Okay. So let's say we have factorial 5, just for the sake of your knowledge. If it is factorial 5, then it can be expanded like this. 5 into, if it is required, you can stop here. So you can write 5 into factorial 4. Otherwise, you can expand like this. 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3. If you are willing to stop here, you can write factorial 3 here. If you want to further extend this, you can write 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2. Again, you can stop here while writing this 2 factorial, or you can expand 2 into 1. So this is a concept of factorial. Okay. And one more mistake basically student are doing in exam is factorial 0. You have to remember this. The value of factorial 0 is 1. Okay. The value of factorial 0 is 1. Okay. So this is very basic thing that I am discussing with you. Okay, now coming to the next concept. That is, if I am talking about this, let's say you have some number of items. Let me write in whiteboard. Let's say we have n number of objects, n objects. And out of these n object, there are m objects m n and k objects are identical. Let's say m and k objects are identical. Identical means same type of object. Same type of object. If objects are identical, that is same type of object is given. So now in this case, the total number of arrangement is something like, if all objects are different, suppose all objects are different, let's say this is an object and all objects are different. If all objects are different, in that case, it is factorial n. But now in this case, m object out of n, this small, let's say I am telling it as p. I am writing it as p. Let's say m, p and k are identical object. Okay. So in that case, you have to divide with m, factorial m, factorial n, factorial, let's say, I taken as p, I taken it as p, so that's a factorial p, and this is factorial k. So sometime some question is like this, how there is a word called, let's say, Mahabharata, and let's say some and how many ways we can arrange that particular word. So in that case, let's say if we have world called, if we have word, let's say Ram, and we have to arrange it. So total number of arrangement with or without meaning, why I am telling this, because not according to the dictionary, there is different arrangement. That's why I'm not talking about this. So if we call it as okay, there is a word called Ram and we have to arrange this with or without meaning, then this is something called factorial 3. Why so? Because there is no repetition of word. That's why it is factorial 3. Let's say a word called Rama. If it is something like R-A-M-A, so let me write in caps. So if it is called Rama, R-A-M-A. Now, if it has been asked that how many ways we can arrange this number, arrange this word with or without meaning, so this is something called factorial 4 divided by factorial 2. Why it is so? Because A is repeated. A is of same type. That's why it is factorial 4 divided by factorial 2. Okay. So Neha is facing some issue. Can you brief me what problem you are facing? Okay, just go through the concept first, whatever I am writing on whiteboard, then we'll brief you about the question. What question is being asked? Okay. So moving to the next section, which is called combination. So combination is, when we talk about combination, it is basically selection. Combination is basically selection. When it is called combination, we have to recall it as the word selection is given in the question. If word selection is given in the question, we have to select something. We have to select some object out of given some object, then you can apply the concept of combination. It is very much essential to recall this as when to apply NCR. So NCR is basically the combination, and formula of combination is, formula of NCR is factorial n divided by factorial r multiplied by factorial n minus multiplied by factorial n minus r. So this is formula of a combination, and we have to apply the concept of combination when there is something called selection of some object. If it is being told that you have to select some object out of given some object, then you have to apply the concept of selection. Okay, let's say we have five object. Let's say we have five object, and we have to select let's say two object out of these five object. So in that case, total number of selection is 5c2, and you can expand it further like this, that factorial 5 divided by factorial 2, that is r, and n minus r will be factorial 3. So now you can expand this factorial, and you can cancel this factorial. You will get the solution like this. If you will expand this, let's say 5 multiplied by 4, and it is very clear that denominator contain the factorial 3. So in that case, it can be written like this: 2 multiplied by 1, I am expanding factorial 2, and then factorial 3. Okay, 4 must be expanded. 4 can be expanded like this: 4 into factorial 3. I will stop here. Why so? Because this factorial 3 and this factorial 3 will get cancelled. If these two get cancelled, and this 2 can cancel this 4, and you will get 10 as an answer. So this is very simple, that you can calculate, and answer is 10. Yes, Ridham, answer is 10. Okay, so this is very basic concept that I am dealing with, because in your CET exam, there is a very basic question in this topic, and as I told you earlier, that this topic is very useful in terms of scoring marks. If you are scoring marks, if you want to score high marks, or you are willing to score good rank in CET, in that case you have to attempt this section also, because this is a critical section, higher mathematics section, that nobody is going to attempt. Okay, and if you pay attention towards this, you will be one of those who are attempting and scoring the higher rank. Okay, so moving towards the so I have taught you about the permutation and combination, concept of permutation and combination. Now moving towards the some basic properties of permutation and combination. So what are those property? So as you have seen, one minute, it's better I will write here. First property is, you have to remember that NC0 is equals to NCn is equals to 1. Okay. And second property you have to remember is NCr can be written as NCn minus r. This is very useful. Sometime answer is given in such a manner that even if you are getting the right answer, but you are not able to choose the correct option. Let's say I'm giving one example here. If you are getting, somehow you are getting answer like 50c40, but what you will observe that none of the answer is written in this form. Okay, but if you will apply the above property, then you may end up like this: 50 minus 40, and it will be something like 50 50 c 10. Then you will observe that one of the option is 50 c 10. So this, that's why I told you that this section is tricky one. This section is basically advanced mathematics section. Okay, and this is basically from the algebra part. Okay, one more property which is very important is if ncx, let me clear it and write it here. Ncx is equals to ncy. Ncy. If ncx is equal to ncy, then there is two case. One case is this n must be equal to the sum of these two, x plus y. Second case is x must be equal to y. Okay, so these are the two cases, and mostly questions are being asked on this property. Okay, so this is very important. Again, now moving towards the last property of combination, which is called NCR plus, and this is again very important. R minus 1, NCR and NCR minus 1. If this is something, then you can end up with this property like N plus 1 C R. Okay, so this is again very important. Okay. So this is all about the concept of permutation and combination. Now moving towards the concept of probability. Okay. So when we talk about probability of some event E, PE, it is something about the how many favorable cases you have and how many total number of cases we have. So this is something called number of favorable event, and it is symbolically it is written like this, NE divided by total number of sample space or total number of trials, you can say. So this is written as NS. So this is the very basic formula of probability, and it is called NE divided by NS. Now very basic thing you have to remember or keep it in your mind, that value of probability is between 0 and 1. Value of probability is between 0 and 1. Whenever we calculate probability, its value never exceed 1, and its value never will be below 1. Below 0, okay. So when it will be equal to 0, now there is a case that when the value of probability is equal to zero in case of uncertain event. Now you have to keep this in your mind, that some event which never occurs is called uncertain event, and the value of probability of that particular event is basically zero. Now there is some event which is called sure event, and probability of that particular event is basically 1. Let's say if we talk about today's Wednesday, okay, then what is probability that tomorrow you will have Thursday? So this is sure event, definitely you will get. So in that case it is equal to 1. If I would say today is Wednesday, and what is probability that tomorrow you will getting Friday? So this is not going to be happen. This is basically unsure event, That's why probability is zero. So this is very basic thing about probability, basic things. And I hope all of you know about the concept of coins, cards. Okay. So again, these two topics are very important. Concept of coins. Coins, just I will give you one minute introduction about this. If you talk about coin, we have head and tail. And the total number of probability is basically 2 raised to the power 2. So probability is basically 2 raised to the power n, total number of trials, where n is total number of toss. So this is very basic thing that you have to keep in your mind. In case of coin, you have 2 raised to the power n. But in case of dice, you have 6 particular events. That's why it will be 6 raised to the power n. So this is all about coin and dice. And one more thing I would like to discuss about cards. I hope all of you are familiar with cards, and all of you are basically I hope all of you are okay. So I am discussing about the cards. So all of you know that there is 52 cards, and out of these 52 cards, we have 4 different types of card: heart, and then diamond, then club, then spade. And these are further, first of all, these are divided into 2 colors, red and black. And then in case of red, we have heart and diamond. In case of black, we have spade and club. So I hope these are basic things. You are very familiar with it. I'm considering that you are familiar with it. Okay. Now when we talk about one more concept we are left with in probability, which is called concept of leap year. Okay. So that will cover in the question. Now I am moving to the question which are asked in last 2-3 year. So very first question is, how many words that can be formed using 3 letters from the word Delhi? So, okay, Neha. Okay, I will brief you. If I will get time, I will brief you about cards. Okay, don't worry. Okay, so now coming to the question section, it is very important. If you pay attention towards the session, if you have written a formula into your notebooks, it is very easy to solve this question. Now, come on, solve this question. So very first question is, how many words can be formed by using 3 letters of the word Delhi? So we have 3, we have to choose, you have to arrange basically 3 letters. We have given some letters. So in case of Delhi, you will get 5 different words. 5 different words we have. Then we have to pick only 3 words. Okay, that's why it is permutation. Okay, we are not going to select words. We have to choose or arrange words. So that's why it is 5P3. And when you will solve this, you will get 60, I hope. Okay, so this is very simple question. So this first question is very simple, and all the question what I am discussing here, or what I will discuss with you, is basically taken from CET. Next question is, how many words can be formed by using the letter of the word GGSIPU? Okay, so in this case, what we have a word called GGS IPU, and there is one condition that we have to pick word in such a way that vowels are always together. Now this is the tricky part. Vowels are always together. So now we'll think like this. If vowels are together and we have word called GGS IPU, so I am taking constant out of it, GGS IPU. So this is P, this is again constant, and I and U are basically vowel. So whenever question comes like this, this is very basic trick that you have to follow. If you are to given that, if it is given that vowel are together, you have to consider, then you have to just think about we are binding this vowel with the help of string so that this vowel cannot move. So now how many words we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We are considering whole I and U as one. Okay. So total number of arrangement. So how many words we have? We have 5 words. That's why factorial 5. Now one concept comes into the picture. What is it? If we have repetition, then we have to divide it, divide that number of, you can say, word. So we have G in repetition here. That's why it is, this question is tricky one. We have two same kind of G. So we have two G, same kind of G. That's why this can be, whether you can write G, this G first or this G first, it does not make sense. Okay. That's why we have to divide this by 2 factorial. Now, some of you might thinking that now this is done. This is not done. Okay. This is not done actually. Why? We are still one step away from this question. We have to multiply this by factorial 2. Why factorial 2? Because we have these two letters in our string. We have binded this string, but we can arrange ones like IU, and again we can arrange like UI. So this is factorial 2. We have to multiply because this can also written like this. So you can easily canceled this factorial 2 and factorial 2, and you will get factorial 50. Okay. So I hope it is clear now. So you are getting factorial 5. So finally you are getting answer as 120. Okay. So 120 is correct answer in this case. Now coming to the third question, in how many ways can a group of 5 member be formed, selecting 3 boys out of 6 and 2 girls out of 5? Okay. Again, in this question, it is very clearly written over there that you have to select. Selection is written here. You have to pay attention towards the word. You might be thinking about applying permutation, but it is very clearly given here that you have to select. Select means you have to apply the concept of combination. So we have 6. We have to select 6 out of, we have to select 3 out of 6 boys. So it is something like 6 out of 3. So you can think like this, 6C3. Okay. And then you have to select 2 girls out of 5. So this is something 5C2. Now total number of, now second, after taking this first scenario, it is like this. And after taking the first scenario, it is like, you might be thinking like this, 5 out of 2 girls you have to select. 5 out of 2 girls you have to select. So now apply the concept of principle of counting. You have to apply you have to apply that concept, and you will multiply end up with the you multiply these two, and you will get the final answer. Okay, so it is something called you will getting B as a choice. Okay, next, try question 4 and try question 4. So again, it is been asked that how many words can be formed by using the letters from the word CETIPU. So if it is given something like this, CETIPU, then how many words can be formed? Okay, so it is very clear that it is asking about the number of words that you are forming with the help of this CETIPU word. And one condition is given over there, such that all the vowels are never together. So you already know the concept of getting vowel together. So what you will do is you will think like this: if we calculate when vowel are together and what is total number of arrangements. If we subtract total minus together, we'll get never together. It is very as simple as that. So if you are subtracting, if you are thinking about the total number of possible words, so it is factorial 6. Okay, let's say 720 I am calculated here. Okay, if you are calculating that vowels are together, then it is 144. Simply you have to subtract and you will be getting your answer. Okay, now coming to the next question. 3 unbiased coin are tossed. What is the probability that at most one head occurs? At most means maximum one head. Okay, so when we toss 3 unbiased coin, one thing you have to remember that tossing 3 coin at a time or tossing 1 coin 3 times, both are same. You will be end up with the same sample space. So when we'll toss 3 coin, you will be getting sample space like this. And I hope it is clear to all of you. It is very simple. You are getting HHH, HHT, HTH, THH, HTT, THT, double TH, and last one is triple T, all tail. Okay, now what is favorable case? Favorable case is at most one head, maximum one head we can allow. So HTT, THT, TTH, and triple T. Triple T means no head. So no head we can permit. Okay, so total number of outcome is 8 and total number of favorable outcome is 4. So that's why your answer is 0.5. Now coming to the 6th question. This sixth question is very important. Okay, and same type of question is being asked in several competitive examination. That's why I am highly recommending that you have to practice this type of question as well. Okay, a bag contains 6 white, 4 black ball. 2 balls are drawn at random from the bag. 2 balls are drawn. Okay, now find the probability that both the balls are of same color. Now it is the condition, it is the tricky part that you have to see. When we are calculating, in this case it is better to draw a figure like this. Just quickly draw a figure that we have 6 white ball, so you can write 6W, and 4 black ball, you can write 4B. Okay, now just suppose that we are drawing 2 balls out of this 6 and 4 balls. So total number of balls we have, let's say 10. Okay. So number of favorable outcome we are thinking like this. We'll selecting like this. We have to select two balls. Okay. And find the probability that both balls are of same color. So same color means we have to either we can pick white ball or we can pick black ball. So it is something like 6C2, either 6C2 or 4C2. In this case, we have to pay attention. If you have to choose, something like either or situation you are end up with. If you are end up with either or like situation, then it is definitely going to be the addition of these two cases. Okay. If you are talking about addition, then you will something get 6C2 plus 4C2. So it will comes out to be 21. And if we'll talk about total number of cases, so total number of cases, how many balls we have? 10 balls, and we have to select 2 out of 10. So it is something called 10C2. So it will be 45. When you will divide this, P equals to, apply the formula of P equals to NE by NS, and you will get 21 divided by 45. So it is 7 by 15. So your answer is D. Okay. Now coming to the next section, question number 4. It is given that how many, just a second, okay. How many words can be formed using the letter from the word CETIPU? So CETIPU se aapko word batana hai kitna aapka banega. Okay, so sabse pehle aap same purana concept aap lagayenge. You have to apply the same old concept that we have CETIPU, and again question is something vowel, all the vowels are never together. All the vowels are never together. So in that case, again, you can apply concept like this. You can evaluate the when vowel are together, and then you will subtract total minus together, you will get never together. Okay, same pattern. का क्वेश्चन है जो हमने अभी प्रीवियसली डिस्कस किया था. ओके, नाउ कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. ओके, आई ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दिस ना. ओके, कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. ओके सर, देयर इज लैग, दैट्स व्हाई. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. So in this case, we have a bag contain 2 red, 3 green and 2 blue ball, and 2 balls are drawn at random. What is probability that none of the ball are drawn is blue? This is different question. So none of the ball is drawn. None of the ball is basically what we have to select, that we have to draw 2 balls, and we are end up with only red or green one. Okay, we do not have to draw this blue ball. So in that case, what we are, what you will do is you have to see that how many balls are given. So it is 3 red, 3 orange and 5 blue balls are given. Except blue, we have 2 different color of ball, 2 red and 3 green. So it is 5 ball. So you have to select out of 5 ball, you have to select. If we are selecting out of 5 ball, we are selecting 2 ball, so this is something called 5C2. And if we are selecting out of 7 ball, 2 ball, so if you are selecting 2 ball out of 7, so it is called 7C2. So this is your favorable case, 5C2 divided by this is the total number of cases, 7C2. So finally you will be end up with this solution. This is something called 10 by 21. Okay. Now coming to the next question, the probability that a non-leap year okay, if you have any doubt you can write in chat box. Okay, next question is the probability that the non-leap year chosen at random has 53 Sunday. This is what I am talking about. That the concept of leap year, you have to be very clear with the concept of leap year and non-leap year. If we talk about non-leap year, if we talk about non-leap year, you know that it has 366 days. And if it is talking about the leap year, then it is 366 days. If it is talking about the non-leap year, then it is 365 days only. Now, if we are having 366 days in case of leap year, when you will divide it with seven, you will get 52 weeks and 2 days. When you will divide, you will get 52 weeks and 1 day. In case of non-leap year, or in case of leap year, you will be getting 52 weeks and 2 days. So in that case, 52 weeks, let's suppose I am getting, and so in case of non-leap year, we have 52 weeks and 1 day, this one day could be Sunday, this one day could be Monday, and so on. So we have one day and we have seven choices. So this is something called 1/7. So it is very easy to remember this concept. Okay, if we talk about leap year, then this concept is slightly tricky. In this case, you will be end up with, as I am talking earlier, that okay. There is some glitch. Okay. If I'm talking about a leap year, then this is about 53 weeks we are getting, and 52 weeks you are getting, and you are getting 2 days. Okay, Rhythm is saying that. Question number 8 again. I am giving you, again I will be discussing this concept if it is not clear. It's okay, I will be discussing it again. See, when we'll talk about the concept of leap year, you have to be very clear that leap year contains 366 days. Okay, and when you will divide this by 7, you will be end up with 52 weeks and 2 days. Just understand the concept. If I am talking about leap year, okay? If I am talking about leap year, it is 52 weeks and 2 days. Then we are getting this 2 days as a choice, and this, in these 2 days, if it is being asked that 53 Sunday, so how you are getting 52 Sunday, you already have with these 52 weeks, 52 Sunday you already have. Now for this one Sunday, you are getting two choice, that this is 2 day. So this is something called 2/7. So 2 is your favorable case. Okay, 2 is your favorable case. So total number of favorable case divided by the total number of sample size. So 2 is your favorable case, and it is 2/7. Yes, 52 weeks and 2 days. So you are getting 2 by 7 in this case. Okay. If you are 2 by 7, yes, 2 by 7 is correct one. Okay. If you are having non-leap year, if you are having non-leap year, in that case, you have 365 days. 365 days. In that case, we have 52 weeks again, and one day we are left with. And one day we are left with. In that case, your answer will be 1/7. Because total sample size is 7 and you have only one option, one day left with. So 1 is your favorable case. Okay, I hope it is clear now. So this is all about this question number 8 and 9. Last question is again very interesting question and very important question, which are basically being asked in CET. That find probability of getting face card from a pack of cards. So how many face card we have? Can anyone let me know how many cards we have? Face card we have, how many face card? So if we'll talk about face card, we have king in playing cards. We have king, queen, and jack. Okay. And we have four king in four different suits. Like we have one king of heart, we have one king of club, we have one king of diamond, one king of spade. So we have four king. Similarly, we have four queen. Similarly, we have four jack. So these are basically face card. Why it is called face card? Why it is called so? Because some faces are given over these cards. So we have 12 face cards in this case, and you have to calculate the probability of getting these face cards. So that's why answer is 12/52. Okay, so your answer is B. Okay, so if there is any question, let me know. So what I am giving you a brief introduction that, okay, Neha is asking, I think I should start playing cards. Okay, just I will give you a brief. Yes, it is break time, Puneet, but I will finish this. I'm finishing this concept of playing cards in 2 minutes and then we'll take break. Okay. So we have 52 cards. Okay. In this 52 cards, we have basically two color. It is very important to note, because question can be asked like, you have to select red color cards, you have to select black color card. So in that case, you have to be very clear about it. We have red color cards and we have black color cards. So it is equally divided. So that's why it is 26-26. Okay. So you have 26 red card and 26 black cards as well. Now in case of red, we have heart. We have heart and diamond. You have heart and diamond. Okay. Heart again, 13 cards. We are having heart, 13 cards. And in case of diamond, we have 13 cards. In the same case, in case of black, we have spade and club. We have spade and club. Again, these are also 13 cards. 13 cards. Now see, if I am talking about this 13 cards. So in this case, these 13 cards, we have ace, we have ace, then we have king, then we have queen, then we have jack, then we have 10, then we have 9, then we have 8, and so on up to 2. Okay, so out of these cards, this king, queen, and jack is having some picture over there. That's what is called face card. Okay, so now I think, Neha, you are clear with the concept of cards. If you have any question, let me know. Otherwise, it is done from my side. I have taught you the permutation. I have taught you the combination, and then I will give you brief idea about the probability.
Okay. Thank you, Tapan sir. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. You are audible.
Thanks, students. And Tapan sir, I think we will be start giving them practice test and certain mock test also from tomorrow, if I'm not wrong.
Yes, ma'am. Students.
All teachers.
Yes, students.
Yeah, we will be giving practice test.
Giving you the practice. Yes, ma'am.
And we will have break and we will resume this session again. I think we can give them 5-10 minutes more because we have already taken their time.
Yes, ma'am.
It was a little difficult also, permutation and combination. So students, we will resume the session again around 12:40. Is that okay with you? Please write in the chat box. We will have reading comprehension. Again, it is very important part of your CET examination. Please write in chat box. Is it okay if we start this session at 12:40 or 12:45 is okay?
Yes, ma'am. Neha is saying yes.
Okay. Puneet is also saying okay. And definitely all the practice tests, our teachers are preparing mock test and practice test for you, beta, for everything they are preparing. So definitely you will get these tests. So don't worry, we'll start at 12:45 and the session is on reading comprehension, because maximum time is wasted, you know, in reading comprehension. So our teachers will be telling you how to read the comprehension and how to solve that reading comprehension, that so that you can score good. So okay, we'll leave for break. We'll again resume the session at 12:45. Thank you, Mr. Tapan.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, all of you.